Hello everyone and welcome back. The other day I got a fabulous video suggestion by Anne Desposito and her dog Wolfie, and I just had to make the video because it just seemed like such an interesting topic. So today we are going to talk about the things that are in my dog walking bag. And this doesn't just have to be for if you have a dog walking business. Like, you can totally use any of these things as little hacks and tips for your own dog as well. So let's see what's in my bag. So what I use for an actual bag is a fanny pack. I know, super lame guys, but trust me, it works very well because it leaves my hands free. I can just like put it around my waist and we're good to go. So this is what I use. I just got this, you know, at a backpacking store. Doesn't have to be anything fancy, but I do suggest that you get one with a zipper because I do keep treats in here, and if there's no zipper, then the dogs are gonna be constantly nosing their way in trying to get the treats. So, zipper, crucial. And then it just clasps right around my waist, just like that. Easy peasy, I can adjust the sides. So this is what I use for my actual bag that I carry, and then I can also hang things off the sides with carabiners. I found that this is the best because it's not too big, not too small, and I can just fit everything in it real nice. Probably the most important thing is the poop bags. This is the most important thing because it is the one object that I know 110% fact that I'm going to use every single day, multiple times a day. So I use earth-rated bags. This is the packaging. And what I like about them is they're biodegradable. They're made out of recycled content, which I really love because I'm using so many of these in a day and I like to feel good about the choices that I make, that they're not gonna be harmful to the environment. I also like them because they're not too thin. Sometimes I find poop bags are so thin that you're afraid it's gonna break and your hand is gonna be covered in, well, poop. So these are really, really great. This is what I use, and I'll keep a couple of rolls, usually two rolls, inside of my fanny pack. Next, I always bring with me dog water bowls and then a big jug of water. Some dog parks, they actually have a watering station, so I don't necessarily need to bring these, but I do try to bring them with me every day anyway, especially in the summer because the dogs are running around and they always need a drink of water. So I like this one because it folds down and then you just pop it right out and it becomes a bowl. So I'll carry usually two or three of these with me, and then I just put a little carabiner on here. And then when it's folded down, I can just hook it into the fanny pack and it just hangs on the side of my body like that when I'm not using it. That way it still keeps my hands free, but I can carry these really easily. Another thing that I will always bring with me is a muzzle. I don't have it with me here right now, it's in the car, but I always bring this with me. I've never needed to use it, thankfully, but I bring it not so much in case the dogs fight, but because if a dog gets hurt, they're more likely to bite. Even if it's the most docile dog in the entire world, if they're scared and hurt, there's more of a chance of a bite. And if I need to check something out, like on the dog's paw or whatever it is, it's just nice for me to know that I'm not gonna get bit when I'm trying to perform first aid or anything like that. Treats are also super, super important in my fanny pack. Pretty much at least once a day, there's a dog that doesn't wanna leave the park. So I have the treats with me in case I need to lure anyone outside of the park. Oftentimes I will have multiple different treats in case dogs have different taste buds, which they do. And I also like to keep it in this little plastic baggie because if I just put it in the fanny pack gets dirty really fast and then it's harder for me to grab too. At least with this, I know that I can just reach in really quick if I need to lure them out of the park. Also, if there's any quiet times, like there's not a lot of other dogs in the park, or if I have a dog that's not necessarily running around a whole lot, but I still want them to get some more exercise and to use their brain and their body a little bit more, then I'll work on some training things with them. And in order to do that, I need the treats. So I always pack treats with me. One thing that I always bring with me, and I don't necessarily carry it with me on the walk, is extra leashes. So I'll carry about 3 or 4 extra leashes and just keep them in my car. I learned this the hard way. A lot of times I'll go to a client's house and they've misplaced the leash or they left the leash in their car or whatever it is, and instead of me spending 20 minutes trying to find their own leash, I can just go and grab one of my own, and that way we're not wasting any time. I'm not searching around for a way to get the dog from the house into my car. So I'll just carry a bunch of leashes along with me in order to do that. And they don't have to be expensive leashes. They can just be cheap ones. It's literally just as an extra spare thing in case you need it. So yeah, that's pretty much what I bring with me. I do also have a first aid kit that I will keep in the car with me, just in case anything happens. And that has human first aid stuff. And it also has dog first aid stuff. And I keep that with me just in case. I haven't had to use it before, but I mean, you never know with dogs. So I keep that with me as well. I will have a list below of all the different things that I just mentioned in case you want to create your own little dog walking pack. I also will have an article post on my website, which I will also link below, listing all of these things and how they can benefit you in your dog walking business or just with your own dog when you're out on walks. Thanks for watching this video again, and thank you so much for the suggestion. If you guys have any other suggestion of things that you want to know, then let me know and I'd be happy to make a video, and we'll see you in the next video.